Well, news now from Karnataka, where the ruling BJP introduced the anti-conversion bill. However, the bill was introduced just when Congress leaders were arriving inside the assembly after a lunch break, and then commotion ensured that over 30 minutes, and enraged by this, DK Shivkumar even tore the bill. Here's a report.
I to introduce.
ನಮಗೆ ಇಂಟ್ರಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಗೆ ವಿರೋಧ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ದು
ನಿಮ್ದ
ಹೌದು ಇಂಟ್ರಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಗೆ ವಿರೋಧ ಇದು ಮೂಲಭೂತ ಹಕ್ಕುಗಳ ಉಲ್ಲಂಘನೆ ಸಂವಿಧಾನದ ಉಲ್ಲಂಘನೆ
ಅಲ್ಲ ಸಿದ್ದರಾಮಯ್ಯ ಒಂದ್ ನಿಮಿಷ ಹೀಗ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಈ ಬಿಲ್ಲು ಅಲ್ಲ ಈಗ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಈ ಬಿಲ್ಲು ಈಗ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅದು ಸರಿ ಇದೆಯೋ ಇಲ್ಲೋ ಹೇಗಿದೆ ಹೇಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ
A controversial anti-conversion bill introduced with controversy. Even as the opposition, the Congress was just entering the assembly, catching them off guard.
ನೀವು ಇರಬೇಕಿತ್ತು ಯಾರು ಬೇಡ ಅಂದಿದ್ದ ನಾನು ಫೋರಂ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಒಳಗೆ ಬಂದಿರೋದು ಫೋರಂ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನಾನು ಒಳಗೆ ಬಂದಿರೋದು ನಾನು ಒಳಗೆ ಬಂದು ಅಜೆಂಡಾ ಹಾಕಿ ಬಿಲ್ ಕಾಪಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಈಗ ಆಯ್ತು ನಾಳೆ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಬಿಲ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಈಗ ಅಶೋಕ್ ಅವರು ಹೇಳಿ ಅತಿವೃಷ್ಟಿ ವಿಷಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಶೋಕ್ ಅವರು ಉತ್ತರ ಹೇಳಿ
An angry Congress state president DK Shivkumar is seen tearing the bill on the floor of the house. The law minister, however, claims no procedure has been violated. The bill, modeled on bills passed by other BJP-run states like UP, lays down stringent conditions for conversion, including sweeping definition of illegal conversion, force, employment, allurement or marriage. Burden of proof that conversion is not illegal lays solely on the person doing the conversion. Person carrying out conversion needs to declare 30 days in advance to district magistrate. Convertees will lose reservation status. Harsher penalties for converting those from SCST communities. Penalties ranging from jail terms of 3 to 10 years. It comes at a time when the Christians in Karnataka have faced a string of attacks, which the community fears will worsen once the bill is passed.
Type of inducements that you are trying to say, perhaps the post that you are taking, it is going to be a little messy affair for the government, first of all, to pinpoint and say, but everyone can accuse, everyone can be considered as criminal. Ultimately, this anti-conversion law is not only anti-Christian law, it is making the Christians, especially the converts, criminals as it were.
At first, the BJP transferred a government officer who debunked the anti-conversion claims. And today, the ruling party went ahead and introduced anti-conversion bill in the absence of the Congress. While the Congress questions the BJP as to what is there to hide, the Christian community says the harsh penalties that range from 3 to 10 years of jail term, now that is a law which gives a free hand to attack and also victimize the Christian community. In Bengaluru, with camera person Kumar, Shrija for NDTV.